championships. Like, he is he's very hesitant, and he doesn't want to take the fight. At least his people. But then again, you know, as a fighter, if we want to fight, then all we have to say is just speak our mind and let our promoters know that we're interested in it. So if he thinks he can beat me, he should have no problem talking with his promoter and asking them to make this fight. I told that to my promoter and my advisors. I want that fight. Let's make it happen. I want to become a three-division world champion. And they did, and now we're this close to confirming it. The only problem is one person in Mexico who is involved in Sanford Promotions who doesn't have the confidence in his fighter. But hopefully that changes real soon. I mean, the fight fans are really, really ecstatic about the fight. They like it. They're intrigued. And I think that we owe them this. We owe them this because this is what we are. We're fighters, and we need to give them the best fight that we possibly can give them. And I think this is one of the top fights that can be made for September 14th.
So, Jesse,
I don't think no one complains about it.
If the fight does happen, how do you break down Jesse Vargas, Jaime Munguia?
Well, first, I think that first we need to wait for Jaime. We've been putting on a lot of pressure, but we need to wait on Jaime's team for him to make the decision whether he takes the fight or vacates his belt. You know, if he doesn't want to fight me, well, then he needs to vacate it. You know, I don't see him looking good if he decides to fight anyone else in the division. And when I'm here calling him out for the past few months, you know, I had this happen to me before, unfortunately, when I wanted to fight Keith Thurman. You know, I was pushing for that fight over and over again, and unfortunately, he didn't fight me. We were supposed to fight in January, in December, and then he got moved to January and of 2000, January of 2017. And, you know, it didn't seem like it was going anywhere. And it's actually become quite frustrating at times because when there's a big opportunity, you know, I try to take advantage of it, but sometimes, you know, it takes two to tangle, and the fighter on the other end is a little reluctant to take the fight. And it seems like we're in the same position again, where Jaime Munguia is thinking twice about the fight between him and I, which he shouldn't. I mean, he holds the WBO world title. That makes him a world champion, and he needs to be willing to take up all comers, all contenders, and I'm one of them. So let's make this fight happen. I think the fans would love it, so we're going to continue to push. We're going to continue to try and make this fight happen, but at the end of the day, it's all in Jaime Munguia's camp. It's all up to them for them just to accept the fight. That's all it takes, and that's what we're waiting on. So hopefully very soon we will hear something back, and then something that we'll be happy to hear, which is the fight is made.
Hopefully it happens. You had a sensational knockout your last fight. But let me ask you this. Gervonta Davis, Tevin Farmer, what do you think?
I think that's a good matchup. It's a good matchup. You have a very defensive fighter in Tevin Farmer, and you also have Gervonta Davis, who is all aggression. You know, he's only offensive. His defense is being offensive. You know, he's a big puncher. He's talented, and he can end the fight at any moment. So I find it very entertaining to see. We'll see if it happens very soon. I also like Tevin Farmer against Jojo Diaz. I think that's another good matchup as well, you know, for the IBF world title. I think that it's going to take him a little longer to make. I think that each fighter will take another fight previous to making the Tevin Farmer versus Gervonta Davis fight. And if they both come out victorious, then I can see it happening next.
Now, Jesse, you fought Manny Pacquiao. You just were ringside for Manny Pacquiao, Keith Thurman. What did you take from that fight? And what do you think, of course, of Pacquiao, Mayweather? And you were very close to Mayweather. I think you're one of the first fighters he ever signed.
Yeah, that's right. Well, when it comes to the Keith Thurman fight versus Manny Pacquiao, I mean, I spoke about it before and I gave my opinion. I just felt that Manny Pacquiao had the experience and he had the speed, the velocity. And I mean, you know, what I said was basically done. You know, he took action and made it a very entertaining matchup, but he was winning most of the rounds. I'm speaking to Manny Pacquiao, but in a very competitive fight because Keith Thurman, you know, he was right on Manny Pacquiao's tail. You know what I mean? For every round, so I give Keith Thurman nothing but credit. I would love to see the rematch because Keith Thurman put on a great matchup. As for Floyd Mayweather and I mean, we have a really good relationship. I have a lot of respect for him, I think, more than anything. I think the respect is mutual. And with him signing me, you know, years ago, I've admired him for many years. And I wouldn't like to see him come back to being inside the boxing ring unless it's just to be a promoter because, you know, he's made a legacy for himself. You know, 50-0, I don't think it should be blemished after so many years of boxing. But we'll see. We'll see. You never know in boxing. And but first, September 14th, hopefully we can make it against Jaime Munguia. I think that we put on a good case and a good fight for everyone. So stay tuned. And the only reason this fight wouldn't be made is on behalf of Jaime Munguia's team.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.